ain't got no friends. Oh, they'll be where that like a Chanel scarf like rainbow. $1,000, this ain't your cloth. You ain't, that ain't no sauce. I can see the noodles made for poodles. I'm thinking about the law Ferrari coupe. 1.8, the option is the roof. Greens is a secret to the youth. Your goals are malnourished. Please spit the juice. Y'all be vaping, I be maiden. Yes. Y'all be aping, I'm Richard Mille Nation. No diamonds, just tourbillon facing. With gears and sprockets, with the sapphire casing.
When I pull up, they notice me. Come and talk to me, like Jodeci. But don't you be too close to me. Them goons you see, let it go for me. I bring them things. I call them, he bring them things. Mucho, I bring them things. Looking so expensive, rings and things. I bring them things. Bring them things. I bring them things.
Here's a little story about a kid from Morocco. Had to show Carlito I was Benny Blanco.
Check it out.
Raindrop. Offset. Plug. We the outlet. Child put me in the box. I'm in the box off. All of face shorty. Socks off. Mac Miller. Reggie Miller. Villa. Shaquilla. Canaries. Back Stella. White Villa. Fresh vanilla, garage like a kill himself. Lauren Hillam, get up. Crib Calabasas on the hill. I had a morning, play. Beatles won't be on the red carpet. Alcatraz bars, crash cars, ain't no future in front. My homies rip your mask off.
When I pull up, they notice me. Come and talk to me, like Jodeci. But don't you be too close to me. Them goons you see, let it go for me. I bring them things. I call them, he bring them things. Mucho, I bring them things. Looking so expensive, rings and things. I bring them things. I bring them things.
To make an impact. It's the Browns going up against the Seahawks. So now let's head on over to rainy Raymond James Stadium in Tampa to welcome in our announcing crew of Brandon Guyton and Charles Davis.
Larry, it's something that Floridians are all too familiar with as the rain continues to fall here at Raymond James Stadium in Tampa. This crowd, as we've come to expect in recent years, as loud as any in the NFL, and they get even louder when their Seahawks are introduced. We're ready for football as the Seahawks get set to do battle with the Cleveland Browns. Welcome again, everybody, with Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gunn, and yes, the rain is falling now, and it is supposed to continue to fall throughout this game. So how do you think that will impact this contest?
Well, first and foremost, both quarterbacks are going to make sure the officials have those dry footballs coming in each and every play and standing over them sometimes with a towel before the center gets up there to snap it. Second thing is the focus of all the guys who handle the football. Do they wear gloves? Do they take them off? Will they carry the ball high and tight to make sure they have good ball security? That's paramount in a game like this.
So out come the Seahawks now for their first possession. And leading them out there, we get a look at their 6'3 quarterback. This is the Oklahoma State alum, Chris Carson, and he's able to plow forward up to about the 29, just shy of the 30. It's a pickup of four, and it'll bring up second down. And the big boys up front in the trenches, what do you think of the O-line, Charles?
I love them because this is a group that's so cohesive. They know what the man next to them is going to do at all times, and they operate as a terrific unit.
See if they stay on the ground for second down. They run again with Carson. And an alley to run. It's a 10-yard pickup and it moves the chains. Well, one unit I know you want to watch is that offensive line. If they keep clearing holes like that, it could be a long night defensively.
No doubt about it, because when they are in sync, as we're seeing so far, where that continuity is there, and you can see that they're playing off of each other while controlling the defensive front linebackers, you're exactly right. It could be a very long night for the defense because someone's going to run for some big yardage.
They'll look to throw here on first down. And running with power here. Oh, he's able to out-muscle him here as he pulls it in. A gain of 32 that time.
There will always be a place for methodically marching the ball downfield. But when you can pick it up in big chunks and strike like that, have explosive plays, that's often the difference in winning and losing. Those types of plays that can knock a defense off balance, that'll drive a team towards a victory.
So after that big gain, let's see what else the offense has up its sleeve. They run it with Carson. And he'll take this down just shy of the 25-yard line. A gain of three, second down. And now the starting defense for the Browns.
Christian Kirksey is starting to come into his own as a linebacker. Rangy, fast, uses that speed to not only outrun blockers, but run down ball carriers. But at the end of the day, tackles really, really well. Second in the AFC in 2016 in total tackles.
Second down following the run. He'll look to throw. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. And they've got it inside the 10 at the 8. 18 yards there, and it'll be a first and goal.
I like the screen being called here early in the game, especially on the opening drive, because, Brandon, when guys come out of the locker room, especially those pass rushers, they are so amped up to get to the quarterback that you can use that against them, and a screen pass is a great way of doing it. A lot of teams against good pass rushing teams, they want to run the screen 10 to 12 times in a game.
First and goal from the 8. They'll try to run with Rawls. And he'll work his way closer to the goal line as he's got five down to the three. So that run gets him about halfway home.
Yeah, it's now second and goal. The end zone beckons. It looms. They can do whatever they want. Full playbook. Run it again, or they can go play action and try and put it in that way.
They'll set up to throw. And he's going to go down just outside of the five, right around the six-yard line. Larry Ogunjobi able to get in there and take him down for a loss of three.
When you're this close to the goal line, you've got to expect pressure from the defense, so the ball's got to come out fast. Got to get out of his hands quicker.
Can this defense get the stop on the opening drive? Here's third and goal. Back to throw. And too much on that one. It's out of the back of the end zone, incomplete.
Let's give this defense some credit now. They let the guys get downfield. But when push came to shove, they stood their ground. And now they'll likely force a field goal attempt.
So on fourth down, Pete Carroll's going to call out his field goal unit. From the right hash here, should be an easy one. And Walsh able to convert it as his kick is good. And the Seahawks grab a 3-0 lead. And the first 3 points of the night belong to our home team as they get the field goal on the game's initial drive.
A good, solid drive. It didn't wind up in the end zone, but that's okay. You've got something positive on the board, and you got the early lead.
The made field goal, Walsh back out to kick it away. That's fielded in the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. So here come the Browns for their first drive on offense. And they will be led out by their 6'4 quarterback. They'll run with a backup. This is Williams. And he'll get this one up to the 26. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and nine. And the Buffet Boys, the O-line, hopefully they're ready today.
Listen, you got to feed them first. But if you do, you usually get a great product out on the field. And when they play well, the quarterback can't wait to feed them afterwards.
So what will they do? On the ground, through the air, let's see. Second and nine.
20.
Back to throw here. Got a man over the middle. It's Williams. And look out, a big hit to the shoulder pads. Took him right off his feet, right around the 31. And this defensive line will be looking to control the point of attack.
And that's what they've done throughout this season. This is a terrific unit. They play together very, very well, and they don't permit big plays to happen.
And on third down, a nickel formation here defensively. They'll drop the throw. Out to the flat. That's complete to his running back. And he went backwards. He'll be down at the 30. A loss of a yard, and it brings up fourth. Really good defensive effort. They were all over that. A little swing pass out to the right side, but for lost yardage.
Terrific read, better execution, and done with a lot of enthusiasm, wasn't it? Yeah,
absolutely.
They saw it all the way, ran to the football, and caused a nice play for lost yardage.
So on fourth down, here's Jake Shum to punt it away. Fielded just inside the 20. 6-yard return after a punt of 48. And it'll be Seahawk football, first and 10. Before the offense changes hands here, let's look back at the Super Bowl February 5th. What a game. I know you were there calling it offensively, though. Impressive on both sides.
It certainly was, and let's face it, if you're in Minnesota, it's cold outside, but you talk about the offenses, they heated up in a big way. And how about Nick Foles, the backup quarterback turned MVP, 373 yards, 3 touchdowns, and of course, the big one receiving on the Philly special.
Quite a story. As you and I were talking about off air, it was just a fluid game, not a lot of penalties, just really clean play.
Exactly the type of game the NFL needed for the audiences at home watching the game, and of course, people in attendance. A really well-played game.
And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. No gain on the play. It'll be second down. And as a defensive end, getting off the ball quickly, swarming to the football, making a tackle. That's what we saw right there.
Yeah, and that's what their job is. And really, a lot of the time, they have to throttle back a little bit in the run game because, you know, those defensive ends, they're like in a sprinter stance. They're just headed straight for the quarterback. That was good recognition on that play to hold them to no gain.
Now he'll look to throw here on second and 10. That is caught by Darbo. 15 yards through the air and a first down.
One thing I can say pretty safely, that route is not called if you don't have a guy who can throw the ball and put some mustard on it. Because if you're going to lollipop it in the middle of the field, bad things usually happen. It takes a strong-armed guy who can rifle it in there, and they were able to successfully complete that one.
And the offense lining up first and 10. Play fake here on first down. Wide open receiver complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before getting this inside the 30. A gain of 32 that time.
Now that play will end up on the highlights, and you'll see it all over the place. But what you won't see, the offensive line that bought the extra time, that allowed for the big completion downfield, those guys made that play possible.
So after that big play, let's see if they can catch their defense maybe on their heels. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll take this down just shy of the 25-yard line. Give him 3 on first down. It'll set up a 2nd and 7.
Well, that call makes sense because they've been throwing it well on this drive. And once again, they show passing formation, showing the shotgun. Then they ran out of it. That's a nice play by them defensively, though, to hold it to a short game.
And before they can run another play, the clock hits triple zeros. And time is up on the first quarter. 3-0 is our score. We'll return to Tampa after this message. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports.
The NFL on EA Sports is presented by Snickers. You're not you when you're hungry. Snickers satisfies.
Alongside my broadcast partner, Charles Davis, Brandon Gauden hits the Seahawks with a football to begin quarter number 2. They face a 2nd and 7 to start things out. Here's here's a play fake as they set up to throw. He's got the tight end, Vanette. That one good for the completion percentage, but no gain. It'll be third down. But he caught it right at the line of scrimmage, and before he could even think about advancing it forward, he got hit.
Great tackling, because that's what you're taught. Don't give up yards after the catch, and most offenses make a living off of yards after catch. Those hidden yards that may not go into the score sheet, but they count big for moving the ball and stretching the field. Really nice open field tackle.
It looks like a nickel set now for the Browns on third down. He'll drop to throw. And this is going to be incomplete. Well, too much oomph, too much mustard there on that pass.
They really turned it loose, didn't they? Really cut loose with that one. Sharp, strong. Didn't lead to a completion, though. Made it very difficult.
And for the second time tonight, this field goal unit comes out here. He hit his first. Now this from 43. And Walsh able to convert it as his kick is good. And that will double their lead as it's up to six. So that scores now in their first two possessions, but it's 6-0, probably not the kind of scores they were hoping for.
No, not at all, but I think that they've shown that they can have some success against this defense. So they'll go back to the sideline knowing the points are going to be there for the taking.
After the made field goal, Walsh back out to kick it away. On the return, Jabril Peppers. And not a bad return. Here he gets it out to the 25-yard line. CD, I want to get your thoughts on some potential free agents this offseason before we change the possession here. Now, caution, many of these guys could be resigned, I know, but who are some of them? Kirk Cousins is one.
Yeah, we're talking about difference makers. Kirk Cousins at the quarterback position, he's going to be coveted around the league by quarterback needy teams. Case Keenum had a big year. Could he move? But how about running backs? Le'Veon Bell, Deion Lewis, some pass catchers, Jimmy Graham, Jarvis Landry, Sammy Watkins. And about the guy who goes and gets quarterbacks, DeMarcus Lawrence had a monster year for Dallas last season.
Yeah, a lot of big names that could be out there as free agents. They begin the drive with Williams. And he's going to lose yardage and be backed up to the 25. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down.
Partner, you mind if I take off this headset and put on a coaching headset?
You want to get this running game going?
I want to get this running game going. I'm going down there and saying, gentlemen, we have got to run the football. We've got to get it going right now.
Yeah, to this point in the second quarter, it has been a struggle. From the shotgun, he'll look to throw, and that'll be incomplete. David Njoku was the intended receiver, and it's third down.
Well, they're slinging it, and then there's one you got to put a timer on, huh? I mean, that one came in hot.
That came in hot, but overthrown, out of his reach, and incomplete.
A nickel look by Seattle on third down.
Yep, five defensive backs now. And now whistles and a flag, and I think we got a jump here.
Encroachment, defense.
So they jumped on the left side of that line.
And you know, when you're at the end spot, you are like in the starting blocks, waiting for the pistol to fire and go, and he jumped a little bit too early.
And on the outside, they're playing press coverage. Now contact up front as penalty markers come in. Who is this against?
Neutral zone infraction, defense.
And he got a little aggressive too early.
And he did, wanting that quick takeoff as the ball was snapped, but I think sometimes those big guys on offense, they're pretty cagey too, right? They make those little sudden moves or those little subtle moves that get you to jump.
Now third down, less than a yard. Now flags will come in. I think this one's going to be on the defense for jumping.
Encroachment, defense.
A little eager there coming in from his outside linebacker position.
You think the hard count got him there?
Yes.
Maybe that extra hut, you know, that extra emphasis on it. Got him to jump, and they picked up 5 yards.
Following the penalty, it's Williams. Trying to turn the corner, but they string him out and stop him at the line of scrimmage. Call it no gain on the play, and it'll be second down. Boy, that's a lot of sirloin steak to be taken down for no gain, partner.
Are you trying to suggest that he is a huge man?
He is
not just a big man,
big,
a huge man.
Big, big boy.
Well, how about the credit then for the defense to be able to chop that big tree and put him on the ground?
I know back when you played, it took four of you to take a guy like that down, right?
Well, that's for sure. And you know what else? I didn't want to challenge him at dinner either.
Got his man complete over the middle. That's Gordon. And he takes this one all the way across midfield into enemy territory down to the 40-yard line. Williams. And this one's going to go the wrong way, losing yardage back at the 42. That's going to go as a loss of two, and it'll be second down.
Well, forget about finding a lane there. He barely had time to look up before he was planted in the backfield. Probably fortunate he was able to hold on to the football.
That's Njoku over the middle. And the stop here will come at the 38-yard line. 4 yards on the completion, and it sets up a third down. Not a big window to throw. Coverage wasn't too bad there.
Yeah, they had him under wraps pretty well, but somehow able to muscle his way open and catch the ball.
And now we've got flags down. Looked like one of the Browns might have moved.
Hostile offense.
And that'll set them back 5. The defense in an enviable position here. The offense needs 13 yards. It's third down.
Set, move, and three.
They're going to look to throw. And it's a short one here, complete to his tight end. And he'll get it down on the play to the 37. The completion good for only 6, and that'll bring up 4th.
So much about this game is just understanding situations and then having to execute, isn't it? Guard the first down sticks. Don't let them get there. And they rallied and made the tackle.
Zane Gonzalez now to try the Browns field goal. This from 54 yards away. pass is going to wind up left. Well struck, but it's no good, and this score will stay right where it is.
I tell you, it's not easy kicking field goals in the best of conditions. Yet in a downpour like we're in right now, it makes it that much harder. And sure enough, they can't convert here.
Charles, earlier we talked a lot about Russell Wilson, what a great job he did last year in 2017 as Seattle's offense is working their way back onto the field. But they're probably going to need to find a running game to alleviate some of that pressure on Wilson, right?
Yeah, you think? I mean, my goodness, when you take a look at what Russell Wilson did, he more than doubled the rushing yardage of Mike Davis, who finished second. And Mike Davis didn't begin the year on Seattle's roster. They went through a number of runners this season, none of them that fit and really hit. Chris Carson, they thought was going to be the guy, got hurt early in the year, but they definitely have to find a running game to get back to playing that Seattle football of run first and let Russell Wilson take over from there.
Credit him with a 1 yard gain there to make it second and nine.
Nice job by that defensive front there to hold him to a short gain on first down. Well played, I must say.
Yeah, only getting 1 yard. There was no room to run. They stay on the ground. Again, it's Carson. And he'll be brought down at the 50 after a gain of about five.
Frustrating for a defense, energizing for an offense. Finding a way to create that type of yardage in your running game, that'll make the guys carrying the ball very, very happy.
From the midfield stripe, they'll look to throw. And it's going to be incomplete. He was able to catch it there on the right sideline, but out of bounds, says the line judge. And it's going to bring up fourth down. A third down, he tried to stay in bounds, did all he could. He caught it, but was led a little bit too far.
Yeah, and that's always difficult, isn't it? Because you know half of your body is trying to stay behind while the other half is reaching out, trying to catch the football. The top half worked. It was the bottom half that was in question.
This is away, but boy, headed straight for the sidelines. So the football switching hands here in just a second. And, you know, Tom Brady, just to go off on a tangent for a second, may have lost the Super Bowl, but third MVP this past season, and what he did at age 40, really something, right, Charles?
Absolutely phenomenal. Ended up beating out Todd Gurley, the running back for the Los Angeles Rams. But he would have traded it for a Super Bowl win, don't you think? How about this? The last nine NFL MVPs to play in the Super Bowl that same season, 0-9.
Yeah.
And all the way back to Kurt Warner in, what, 1999, where he won the double?
We were going over that stat earlier. That is hard to believe.
But he would have been the MVP had the Patriots pulled that one out.
Yeah, he still has five rings, though, five Super Bowl titles for Brady. And takes this one across the 35 to the 36, a gain of about four. Tough running there. That's a hard-earned 4 yards.
Yeah, those are the unsung kind of runs. They don't fill up the stat sheet, but they do set you up in good position on second down.
They don't need to run another play here before the two-minute warning. Let's see if they do it anyway. Now back to throw. Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete. And getting this just shy of midfield, they'll spot it at the 49. Don't forget, coming up at halftime, we'll take you to Orlando and Larry Ridley. Larry will have the highlights of this first half, but he won't have touchdowns because we haven't had any to this point.
But there's still time, though, partner.
They'll look to throw, and he whips that one incomplete there.
The one thing that I've liked defensively is that they've shown him a lot of different looks here in the first half. They've come after him. They've sat back. I think that's what you need to do to keep an offense guessing.
And they certainly have kept them on their toes. That's why they haven't had much success on the scoreboard. Back to throw now on second and 10. It's caught on the right side, Williams. And he takes this one down all the way near the 30. A good pickup there of 20 yards.
Thus far, it hasn't been a real fun half for them, but a play like that, that may get them off the schneid a little bit, get them loosened up and moving.
Kind of seems like they've been sleepwalking and still sitting on 0 points.
And it's not always making an adjustment. Sometimes it's just going back to what you know can work and finally getting it done.
Complete to the tight end. And he'll be a little shy of the 25 here at the 26-yard line. That throw good for 4. It's second down.
Well, the strategy was evident there. Get it to your tight end and make it a one-on-one play with a cornerback. Who's usually going to win that one?
The tight end, but not there.
Not in this situation. How about the corner defeating that logic and making a really nice tackle?
They'll set up a throw. And he's going to go down here. A sack. They push him back to the 34. And now maybe they want some extra time to talk about this third and long play as we'll get a timeout. As they get the stoppage with a little over 50 seconds to go in the first half. Through the contact. Incomplete.
This defense is not going to make it easy for you. They're a physical group, and we just saw it there on that play. He came in, made the contact, just as he's trying to haul it in.
Zane Gonzalez now to try the Browns field goal. He's going to need a little mustard on this one. It'll be a 51-yard attempt. And this one looks good. It is good. Right down the pipe. And they are on the board, trailing now 6-3. A little bit of a lower trajectory there on the deep kick, and it worked.
Had to do it because he had to drive it out low because of the length of the kick. Able to do that, got it above the defense and over the post.
After the field goal, here's Gonzalez to kick it off. This is fielded at the goal line. And not a bad return here. He gets it out to the 25-yard line. I want to give a hat tip real quick, Charles, to J.J. Watt before the possession switches here. Walter Payton, NFL Man of the Year. They totaled up how much he helped raise for hurricane relief, $37 million.
Incredible. Hurricane Harvey, which really hit the Houston area in a big way, and his original goal was $200,000. So congratulations to J.J. Watt and all the people who participated. And Greg Olsen of the Panthers, Benjamin Watson of the Ravens, both tight ends, also nominated and finalists for the most prestigious award as determined by the NFL, the Walter Payton Man of the Year Award.
They'll come out throwing here on first down. And he spins through. It's a short one here, complete to his tight end. And before this second down play, we'll get a whistle, a signal, and a timeout. As the clock will stop with 33 seconds to go in the first half. And we're back. The offense had a chance to talk things over. We'll see what they come up with here on this next play.
Come on,
This is Carson, and he's got room. He'll be tackled shy of the 35. Shifty footwork gets him a little extra on the play. It's a six-yard run, leaves him with about a foot or so here still to go to hit the marker with third down coming up.
Offensive linemen love creating space for their guys carrying the ball, but when that guy also breaks tackles and creates extra yardage, they almost feel like he's one of them, and they really embrace him.
So if you like field goals, this is your game. 6-3, three field goals at the break. As we will toss it an hour or so east of here to Orlando, that's where we check in with Larry Ridley with our EA Sports Halftime Report.
Okay, Brandon, thanks, and welcome everyone to our EA Sports Halftime Report. Let's get to the highlights. Both the Seahawks and the Browns haven't had a reliable run game so far. The push up front has not been there, and you have to give credit to both defenses on that front. So here we go. Let's take a look at some of the highlights from the first half. Seahawks still on the field. Defense is going to come away with the sack. This ends up with a short loss in yardage. Late in the first quarter, McAvoy's by himself here, and he ends up at the 29-yard line before he stopped on the play. Browns line up at the 26. Defense will get to the QB here. This will go for a loss of 8. So that's it for us. We'll go back now to Tampa for the start of the second half.
Okay, Larry, thank you. No touchdowns in our first half. What will we see in half number 2? Time to find out. So both teams have their marching orders, and we'll get going again here in quarter number 3. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And he'll take it up past the 25 to the 26-yard line. Here's the Browns offense now getting set to start off this third quarter. They're close game, but they're going to need to do a little bit better probably here in half 2, no?
I would agree with that totally. I would guess that in the locker room, they talked about cleaning up some of the errors, but overall, I think they wanted to be positive with them. Guys, we're right there, just not playing as well as we need to. Let's pick it up, and we still have a chance to win this game.
Yeah, they do. We'll see if they can pick it up. Play action here on first down. His throw incomplete. Josh Gordon, the intended receiver. That'll bring up second down. Well, pretty good coverage there, and both of these defenses, they've had good coverage throughout this one.
No doubt about it. And in today's NFL, where we're used to a bit more scoring, this feels almost like a well-pitched game in baseball on both sides, where the tension continues to build. Who's going to make the big play?
Second and 10. He'll look to throw again. And that one got tipped. Kind of threw everything off. It brings up third.
So much of this game is about leverage. We always talk about low man wins in the trenches. Well, it's like that at just about every position. And sometimes, if you lose that leverage and you're losing the battle, just jump up at the line of scrimmage and try and bat the ball away. And that's exactly what happened there.
He'll look to throw. Throwing for his running back, and he's got him complete. And they'll take him down at the 31-yard line. It's a gain of 5 on the play, and it'll be fourth down.
One hallmark of good defenses is understanding the game, understanding positioning, and tackling immediately in the secondary after catches. I think we just saw that on display right there.
Got to him before he ever had a chance to think about turning it upfield. He gets this one away, and boy, it's another boomer. And a fair catch signaled for and taken just outside the 20-yard line. So possession goes over here on the punt. And out will come the offense as they take over. Now we'll see what this Seahawks offense has in store with their first possession of the second half. They have the lead here. Well, we talk a lot about pregame speeches. What are halftime speeches like?
For the most part, not nearly as emotional. They're a lot more clinical. Every now and then, though, they'll get after you if they think they need to light a fire. But in this case, let's go into the virtual locker room, because here's what I think happened. They got in there and they said, listen, let's take control right away. Defense,
we got the lead.
Defense, don't give up any points. Turn the ball back over to the offense and let them go down and score and give us more of a cushion in the game. Check so far. Defense shut them down. Let's see if the offense gets done.
He was trying to get it there to Kenny Lawler. And that'll bring up second down.
I know our vantage point might be a little bit better way up here, but that looked like an ill-advised throw to me. I didn't see anything open, and this play just didn't look right from the beginning.
It did not. I thought he might get outside and just chuck it away. Dangerous pass, incomplete. Now it's Carson. And he'll get about three as he takes this up near the 25.
Well, that's a good start to this drive on the defensive side of the ball.
Force the incompletion on first down, then you're able to shut down the running play on second.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised now. A little bit of pressure going at the quarterback in the expected passing situation.
The Seahawks on third down, 0 for 3 to this point. They could use a conversion. This is third and 7.
Green, 39.
Looking to throw. And he's got his man. It's Darbo. A gain of 26 on the third down conversion. Offense comes to the line now, first and 10. Here's Carson. And some room to roam now. And he'll be taken down, but not before getting this inside the 30. That good for 22 and a first down.
Well, partner, I have to say they caught him in the right defense there. Nickel set. Fifth defensive back on the field, and they love to run against that because now you typically get a bigger blocker on a smaller defender.
Yeah, because those DBs like you, they want the interception. They're not as worried about the running play, right?
Not at all. And I still remember being in school, and one of my offensive line teammates used to say, boy, I'd love to come downfield, hit you little people.
Good run there. To throw now on first down. Quick hitter here. It's complete. It's a loss of 2 there, bringing up second down.
Well, I know it goes against the instincts of the person catching the ball because all you're ever taught is catch the football, don't drop it.
But drop it there.
Yeah, in that situation, dropping it would have been better. End up losing yardage even though they completed the pass.
As good as a sack.
Yeah, how about that? Although they won't get the same credit for it, and it won't help them at contract time.
Now a handoff looking right. Oh, he's got some breathing room. And down inside the 15, shy of the 10. 17 yards on the pickup there, and the drive will continue.
This has been a good drive so far. It's been the running game for the most part that's powered them down there. Another nice burst there, picking up a first down. Now it's first and 10, as you said, in the red zone.
So they're operating in the red zone.
Here we go now. Green, 39.
Now on first down, he'll drop to throw it. This will be caught at about the 6. And he'll be brought down here at the 3-yard line. Give him 9 there on the first. first down completion.
Seeing that play and understanding just how tough it is to cover tight ends, especially the ones running around the NFL nowadays, makes me glad I didn't make it in that league. I would have had a really difficult time.
But now you get to sit up here with me.
Yeah, and that's fun, isn't it? And what a really nice game right there on first down for them. Brings up a nice second down for them.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll get blown up behind the line of scrimmage. Back at the six. So he loses 3 yards there. Now third down.
We all have habits. We can be somewhat predictable. And you know me pretty well on second down and short. What I like to see?
Play action.
Yeah, without a doubt. I thought that was a great spot to call it. Instead, didn't go their way, did it?
No, defense sold out for the run. Worked out well. The Seahawks on third down. They've only converted once in 4 tries. This is third and 4. He'll look to throw. Oh, it's a touchdown if he holds on. Instead, it's fourth down.
I know every offense wants to start their snaps closer to the goal line, but it's actually harder to throw the ball in those situations. You throw into that tight coverage, you see what happens. Hard to get the ball in there.
Not enough space there. Lucky maybe that it wasn't intercepted. And Walsh able to convert it as his kick is good. And the lead will increase to 6 now. It's 9-3. So 3 field goals for him here, and this last one helps him stretch out the lead.
And he's been solid as usual. And this is what you need to do. Make sure you get points out of every possession. And so far, they've done a nice job of that.
The made field goal, Walsh back out to kick it away. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And he'll bring it a few past the 20 to the 23-yard line. And now the Browns coming out on the field. These guys had to punt last time. It has not been a very fruitful game offensively thus far. They haven't even made a trip to the red zone.
And I know that everyone's going crazy on that sideline because that drives you berserk to come off the field, not really move the ball well. As you said, not even get to the red zone, let alone, you know, not even put points on the board. They've got to just take a deep breath, relax, try and figure out what is working, and call more of that.
They'll try to get this running game going with Williams. And he'll be taken down right around the 27. 5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up 2nd and 5.
Well, they're hoping that the second half is better for him than the first half. They've got to find a way to get him going. He's a big part of their offense.
2nd and 5. To throw, and he's going to be wrapped up and driven down. Malik McDowell breaking through to get him for a loss of 7.
Sometimes I watch games and wonder why they use play fakes on certain passing situations, because it's not going to fool anyone. I don't know if that was the case here, but the end result was the same. No one fooled. Quarterback was hit.
The Browns on third down. Not good. 0 for 4 thus far. This is third down and 12. The play action fake. They'll look to throw. That's complete. It's Gordon. And he'll go out of bounds across the 35-yard line. A good play there as the Browns strike for 16 and a first down.
And that's how you pick up a first down. Not only does he make the catch, but has enough body control to get his feet down inbounds, toe-tapping and dragging to make sure he gets it done.
And on this challenge, the refs have to take a peek and see whether or not the receiver is able to dot the I with both feet.
While making sure that he possesses the football all the way through the catch.
They got a little bit of a breather. Now they're back and set as we resume play. Down, he'll drop to throw. It's a short one here, complete to the tight end. And he'll bring it up here to right at the 40-yard line. That throw good for four. It's second down.
It's vitally important to wrap him up immediately because if you let that big guy get a head of steam up, boy, then you've got real trouble trying to get him down.
But they're able to hold him to a short gain on first down. Set up to throw, and he fires one that's intercepted. Picked off near the 42, and they'll start with great field position at the 41-yard line.
Okay, partner, no surprise to you. I'm going to look at this from the defensive perspective. In the rain, you have to be more cautious trying to cover passing routes. Why? The offense knows where they're going with the football. The receiver knows the route he's going to run. You have to make sure you keep your footing underneath you.
The Seattle now ready to march out of the field. And they had 3 points last time, but they didn't want 3 points because they were well within range of scoring a touchdown. We'll see if they can do better now.
I'm with you on that one. Let's just go ahead and be frank about the whole thing. The only one happy about the 3 points?
The kicker.
Exactly. He put it through the post. That's going to help him at contract time. But that offense, they're thinking, let's get in the end zone this time.
I don't know if that helped him at contract time. You could have kicked that one through.
I don't know about that.
Toe bash.
I don't know about
toe
that.
Bash,
super toe.
Looks like the defense in press coverage here.
All right, now, lucky 56. Lucky 56.
Then he'll give it here to his running back. And very little there. He might have gotten a yard. Yeah, I think he got a yard to the 41.
This is what happens sometimes when you abandon the running game. It's hard to get back to it because once guys get out of that mentality of firing out and hitting people, hard to get them started again occasionally.
They run a draw here on second down, and he's going to get this inside the 30. That one goes for 13 yards, and it moves the sticks.
They're trying to show that they can run the ball, protect this lead, give it to the backs, play a little bit of keep away, don't you think?
And that's probably a good philosophy at this point, going to make that defense stand up and stop them. So the run gets them the first, and now they operate with a fresh set of downs. Now a handoff here to his running back. And he'll be dropped at the 23 after a pickup of about four.
If you're a football guy, that's a pretty run because everyone is in sync right there. Obviously, the guy carrying the ball, but how about the people up front? Leverage, athleticism, they created some nice space for him.
Now in Tampa, it's the Seahawks with the possession. They also have the lead here as we get set for the fourth and final quarter. And they're 6 yards away from picking up the first here on second down. Now they try the right side here. Oh, and now he bowls him over. And down inside the 15 he goes. A nice pick up there, 10 yards, and it'll move the sticks.
Do my eyes deceive me, or is he getting stronger as this game moves along?
Burst seems just as good here in the fourth as it was way back in the first, doesn't it?
I do believe someone put a lot of time in the offseason and continues to condition during the season in order to continue to carry the ball at this rate.
And to give this time to the tailback. And this play goes nowhere. Losing yardage back to the 15. That's going to go as a loss of two, and it'll be second down. And in this situation with a lead fourth quarter, they're liking keeping the ball on the ground, I'm sure.
That's just smart football, but you know the defense has to know it as well. They've got to stop them here. So now we're going to see that loading the box in a big way. 6, 7, 8, 9, whatever it's going to take, puts a little bit more pressure on your big offensive line.
And he'll give it here to his running back. They showed off a nice juke of the defender before the next wave could bring him down. A nice job there as he rumbles for 9, and it'll be back to a 3rd and 3.
Well, that last run makes this a 100-yard night. I've loved the way he's hit the holes. He's been quick, he's been decisive, and he's been a whole lot of fun to watch.
The Seahawks on 3rd down, just 1 for 5 to this point. Here it's 3rd and 3.
Here we go.
They'll drop to throw. And a big loss here as he's taken down. Christian Kirksey able to drop him for a loss of 12. And it'll be 4th down. And they brought the pressure there just right up the gut, didn't they?
Yeah, they certainly did. And, you know, when you've got so many different responsibilities as an offensive line, you got to deal with the nose tackle, the two defensive tackles or ends, and then sometimes you just can't account for everyone. The linebacker slipped free.
So on 4th down, out trots the kicker in a big spot here. This to make it a 2-score game. And Walsh able to convert it as his kick is good. And the lead stretches to 9. It's now 12-3. So a big one there as that gives them a little cushion.
And you know, here in the fourth quarter, the fact that they were able to bleed some time off the clock and put points on the board, even if it's only 3, that could turn out to be the drive that ultimately wins them the game.
Now after the made field goal, Walsh back out to kick it away. This one fielded at the 5. And he'll get it up to about the 26-yard line, just across the 25. And now Cleveland geared up to take the field.
And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious, because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack them here. Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw.
Sometimes the coverage is so good, no matter what you're doing on offense, you just can't shake anyone free. They try their best to find someone open, but they took away every passing alley, every angle, and shut the play down.
Unable to connect on the first down pass play. Now it's second down. To throw here, and this time he's got the hookup. It's complete, and he'll get it up to the 33-yard line. The reception good for 7. It's third down.
They gave up the completion there, but this is what zone defenses count on: catching the ball and not much run after the catch.
The Browns on third down, just 1 for 5 to this point. This time it's 3rd and 3. They'll try and run for it. Here's Williams. And he'll get this only up to about the 35. Only a yard on the pickup there, and it's going to leave them with a fourth down.
So many things go into making a good play on defense. In this situation, just not being blown out of the way was a big start, and then a nice tackle to finish things off.
Indeed going to go for it here on fourth down. So trailing here in the last quarter. Let's see how this plays out. They run. It's Williams. He needed a yard. He didn't get anything. And the Seahawks, they'll get the football back in outstanding field position. So they really needed points here in a 2-score game. Could not come away with anything there on fourth.
And while we know they're a little bit discouraged here, they can't check out of this game. You and I have called a good number of games over the course of our career where we've seen these types of situations. Teams get the ball back, and that miracle does occur. So they can't let that dream go just yet. They have to get stout on defense here.
Yeah, right now, really hoping for a turnover. Really nice starting field position here for the offensive unit. Now a play fake here on first down. He's just going to dump this one off to his fullback out of the backfield. And he'll get this one down to about the 20-yard line. A solid gain of 15 yards and the sticks move.
What may seem a little unorthodox to some people, got the lead, fourth quarter, yet he's still firing away. I think he believes that's the best way to go ahead and win the game.
Yeah, a lot of coaches say, let's just run the football, be conservative. He's sticking to his game plan.
No, that is his game, and that's what they're going to ride.
Clock running, under 4 to play now as they come up on 1st and 10. Now a handoff here to his running back. And maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line. It'll wind up being a loss of 2. And that'll make it 2nd and 12.
Brandon, it's clearly a running situation when you're up in the fourth quarter. They're going to have to stack the box and make it difficult for them to move the ball.
Made it very difficult right there. Now they need to repeat that effort.
Yeah, bring 7, 8, 9, whatever it's going to take to slow them down.
He'll drop to throw. Now they go screen. It's complete. And he'll be brought down at the 21, just shy of the 20 in the red zone. Only a yard there. Sniffed out well defensively, and it brings up third.
So many things have to come together just right for a screen pass to break for big yardage. The blocking, the timing of the pass to the runner, everything has to fit together just right. But on that play, the defense was able to disrupt things and hold it to a short game.
The Seahawks on third down. They've had their troubles, just 1 for 6. This is third and 11. They'll hand to Rawls. And he'll at least get him inside the red zone here, down to about the 19. Just a gain of 2 there, and it's going to bring up a fourth down. So on fourth down, out trots the kicker in a big spot here. Time for a break. We'll come back and see this one out after this. So it's Seahawk football as we march toward a conclusion. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. So on fourth down, out trots the kicker in a big spot here. It'll be from the right hash, and it'll be a 36-yarder. And Walsh able to convert it as his kick is good. And that's going to bump up their lead now to 15-3. So yet another field goal to end a drive. That has been a very common theme. He's now hit 5 of them in this game.
Yeah, Brandon, as an offense, you hate that you've had to call on your kicker so often, but you have to love the fact that time and time again, he's come through.
After the made field goal, Walsh back out to kick it away. This will be fielded at the 6. And he'll take this across the 25. A couple extra yards up to the 27-yard line. And now Cleveland geared up to take the field. And on that last drive, went for it on 4th, turned it over. A good job by their defense, though. They held them to 3, but this offense, they've got to be a little bit better, a little bit more careful here.
And sometimes when you see these calls on 4th down, when they decide to go for it, it's not necessarily the coach saying, I believe in my offense. Sometimes the coach saying, I believe in my defense. I can afford to go for it here, because if we don't get it, I don't think we'll give up more than 3. And that's exactly what happened there.
You think that factored in?
I do. I think that he had that in his mind going into the game, that I'm going to be aggressive on offense because I know I've got a defense that can hold up their end.
It's a short one here, complete to his tight end. And he's able to get out to the 32, brought down there. 5 yards on the catch there, brings up 2nd down. Oh, there's that man again. It's complete. And he'll get it up near the 35, right at the 34 here. And before they can run this 3rd down play, we're going to get a timeout as they'll talk it over here before what will be an important 3rd down. And welcome back. The offensive unit, they took the timeout. And now they get set to line up as we resume action. The Browns on 3rd down. They've had their troubles, just 1 for 6. Here it's 3rd and 3. He's got a man. It's Williams. And he will have a 1st down here at about the 40. It'll go as a gain of six that time, and it moves the chains as well. And it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down.
That would have been a great catch, but it's real difficult to hold on to it because it was contested all the way. Would have been a great play if he had been able to haul that one in.
Now he'll look to throw here on second and 10. And the Seahawk defense gets to him, and they bring him down. And now maybe they want some extra time to talk about this third and long play as we'll get a timeout. As he'll talk it over here before what'll be an important third down. And we are back here. I'm Brandon Gaughan alongside Charles Davis. So the offense takes the timeout. And now we're set to get going. The Browns on third down, lacking much success, just 2 for 7 to this point. This will be third and 19. Nowhere to go here. He lost the football, and the Seahawks have picked it up. Well, they are going to take over right there at the 22-yard line.
Well, that drive wasn't a case of wanting to put points on the board. It was needing
they
to,
having to,
and they didn't get it done.
Yeah, didn't get it done, and now you look at the situation and the point differential, 2 scores, pretty much game, set, match.
How about the takeaway, though, huh? How about those defensive guys?
And out now come the Seahawks. And after the field goal last time, we'll see what they can get here. At least they got points out of the last drive, Charles.
I never met an offensive coach that didn't want a drive to end with a kick. Most of them want it to end with a PAT, right? In this case, a field goal, they'll take it. Way better than the alternative, which is a punt.
Yeah, but you met fan bases that wanted that, that weren't happy with that field goal.
I haven't met a fan base yet that wants a drive to end with a kick other than the extra point. That's it.
The D can only stop it one more time as they take the knee. And now we're going to get a timeout here called by the defense. It'll be their third and final timeout, so as they talk things over, we'll step aside. The Seahawks in victory formation as they go ahead and take the knee. Down to a knee one more time, and that should just about do it. And well, they could just run this clock out, but here is the field goal unit on fourth down. This from 44 yards out, left hash. Well, Charles, the forecast called for rain throughout the entire game, and we got rain throughout the entire game. But these two teams, they had fun getting dirty out there. They love the slop.
Did you trust the forecast ahead of time? Are you one of those guys
I'm a little
skeptical about it, or did you trust it?
But when I saw just a big blob of green on the radar, I said, okay, let's trust.
Yeah, and that's why I'm glad you took my advice. Got your notes laminated, because, you know, open air, boom. That rain can affect us as well, although not as much as the guys on the field. But let's face it, it's kind of fun to watch these types of games, isn't it?
It is. By the way, how impressive is it that you travel with a laminator? I didn't even know there was a portable laminator.
The things that you learn.
Golly, wise beyond his years. So that'll do it for my partner, Charles Davis, and the best darn crew in the industry. I'm Brandon Gaughton. This has been a presentation of the NFL on EA Sports. With that, we bid you good night from Tampa.